Come on, everybody, just put your hands together like that.
Know about my Jesus? What do you know about my Jesus? Come on. God is a good, yes he is. God is a good God. Yes he is. Yes he is. Oh yes, yes, yes. My God is a good God. Amen. Welcome to Restoring Souls to Christ radio show. Tonight we get ready to get started. Hey man, we just want to crank it up a bit tonight and just give God some praise. I don't mind giving God the glory because I know who woke me up this morning. I know where my help come from. Amen. Come on. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes. Come on. Let's praise him. Amen. Let's give the woman of God a hand clap.
Good evening, and welcome to Restoring Souls Back to Christ radio broadcast. I'm your host for this evening, Pastor Brenda D Wilson of Duncanville, Texas. Before we go any farther, let us go to the throne of grace. Father God, in the name of Jesus, because of who you are, God, we give you glory. And because of who you are, we give you praise. On tonight, I ask that you step up and increase and help me to stand back and decrease that you may get the glory. Holy Ghost, you speak through these lips of clay that the people of God will be blessed, someone will be set free and delivered, and someone will cry out, what must I do to be saved? And we thank you and we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Good evening, good evening, good evening. I'm excited about the Word of God on tonight. Our scripture will be coming from Judges, the 16th chapter, and it will be quite a few verses. So I pray that you could stay with me, because we're going to go somewhere with this. It's chapter 16, starting at verse 4. And it's a very familiar story. It's about Samson and Delilah. And the Word of God reads, "And it came to pass afterwards that he loved a woman in the valley of Sorek, whose name was Delilah. And the lords of the Philistines came up unto her, and said unto her, Entice him, and see wherein his great strength lieth, and by what means we may prevail against him, that we may bind him to afflict him. And we will give thee every one of us 1,100 pieces of silver. And Delilah said to Samson, Tell me, I pray thee, wherein thy great strength lieth, and wherewith thou mightest be bound to afflict thee. And Samson said unto her, If they bind me with 7 green withs that were never dried, then shall I be weak and be as another man. Then the lords of the Philistines brought up to her 7 green withs which had not been dried, and she bound him with them. Now there were men lying in wait, abiding with her in the chamber. And she said unto him, The Philistines are upon thee, Samson, and he brake the whips as a thread of tow is broken when it toucheth the fire. So his strength was not known. And Delilah said unto Samson, Behold, thou hast mocked me and told me lies. Now tell me, I pray thee, wherewith thou mightest be bound. And he said unto her, If they bind me fast with new ropes that never were occupied, then shall I be weak and be as another man. Delilah therefore took new ropes and bound him therewith, and said unto him, The Philistines are upon thee, Samson, and there were liers in wait abiding in the chamber, and he brake them from off his arm like a thread. And Delilah said unto Samson, Hitherto thou hast mocked me, and told me lies. Tell me wherewith thou mightest be bound. And he said unto her, If thou weavest the 7 locks of my head with the web. And she fastened it with a pin, and said unto him, The Philistines be upon thee, Samson. And he awaked out of his sleep, and went away with a pin of the beam, and with the web. And she said unto him, How canst thou say thou I love thee, when thine heart is not with me? Thou hast mocked me these 3 times, and hast not told me wherein thy great strength lieth. And it came to pass, for she pressed him daily with her words, and urged him, so that his soul was vexed unto death, that he told her all his heart, and said unto her, There have not come a razor upon my head, for I have been a Nazarite unto God from my mother's womb. If I be shaven, then my strength will go from me, and I will become weak and be like any other man. Verse 18, And when Delilah saw that he had told her all his heart, she sent and called for the lords of the Philistines, saying, Come up this once, for he hath showed me all his heart. Then the lords of the Philistines came up unto her, and brought money in their hand. And she made him sleep upon her knees. And she called for a man, and she caused him to shave off the 7 locks of his head. And she began to afflict him, and his strength went from him. Verse 20, And she said, The Philistines be upon thee, Samson. And he woke out of his sleep and said, I will go out as other times before and shake myself. And he was not that the Lord was departed from him. But the Philistines took him and put out his eyes and brought him down to Gaza and bound him with fetters of brass. And he did grind in the prison house. Howbeit the hair of his head began to grow again after he was shaven. Glory to God. This evening, I would like to share another conversation with you that me and the Father had in my spirit. And I asked if I could share it so you may be blessed and enlightened as I have been. And in this conversation, I did more listening this time than talking. And in my listening, he spoke to me in my spirit and told me, stop giving away my power. The power that he gave me, because the word of God declares in Acts 1 and 8, that after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, you shall receive power. And he kept speaking to me, saying, you've been giving away your power in the natural by trying to please man, by trying to get and keep friendships and relationships that sometimes drain you of your power. He reminded me that some relationships are seasonal, and as I grow in him, or as I grow, because this is for, as you grow, this is for you also, that everybody and everything won't grow with us. So I heard in my spirit, stop giving away your power that I gave you to try to keep people and things in your life. You need to let go so you can keep your spiritual and your natural power. So when he sends me out to do his work, that I won't be drained and can't fully function. So my brothers and my sisters, let's take our power back. Let's begin by first forgiving, because when we don't forgive, we give that person our power. Secondly, he spoke in my spirit just today to stop telling everybody about your blessings, because everybody's not happy for you. We see in these scriptures that Delilah used Samson's love for her to take away his power. And she did it out of greed and deceit. Samson was teasing her at first and told her different things about where his power came from. But when she used the old familiar phrase, if you love me, you'll tell me. And because he wanted to impress her, Samson gave away his power. And I believe he gave it away naturally and spiritually so. So just as Samson wanted to please Delilah, sometimes we want to please people, and we give them power over us. If you want to grow in Christ and stay connected with him, let's receive the power he offers us, because only what we do for Christ will last. If you give your power to man, then you give them control of your life. So why not take your power, your Holy Ghost power, back and give the Lord control of your life, and you won't go wrong. Glory to God. I thank God on tonight. Take your power back. Take your power back. And I can say this with a clear heart and a clear conscience. Several once upon a time, I gave my power away. I had unforgiveness in my heart, so I had to check myself and take my power back. I had hate in my heart, so I had to check myself and take my power back. I had jealousy in my heart, and I had to check myself and take my power back. So I thank God on tonight. I honor him on tonight for his grace and his mercy. So I say unto you tonight, my brothers and sisters, don't allow the trials and the tests of life take your power away. God gave us his Holy Ghost power. He gave us natural power that we can make good choices with a sound mind, because his words declare, let this mind be in you that is also in Christ Jesus. So take your power back. If you've given somebody your power by allowing them to come into your life and dictate your life, tell you where to go, how to dress, you give it to them. That's a type of abuse, and you need to take your power back. Well, I'm speaking generally today or tonight on your natural power. Now, each one of us have the strength within ourselves to take our power back, because God gives us a mind, and we can decide whether we'll accept the right or accept the wrong. And if we accept something that's going to be a problem with us, that's going to keep us from fully functioning for Christ, we need to take our power back. And every time we allow people to control us, whether it be our minds, whether it be our circumstances, whether it be our finances, whether it be in church, whether it be out of church, wherever it is, when we allow people to take control of our thought process and we don't think for ourselves, we're giving up our power. So I just want you to know on tonight, I want you to think about it. I want you to pray about it. I want you to seek God diligently, because that's my heart's desire, is to seek God diligently on how to keep my mind steadfast on Him, that I may keep the power that He have restored unto me. So tonight, I'm saying to you, I'm saying to myself, we got to take our power back. As people of God, and even if you have not accepted Christ as your Savior on today, you still have choices that you can make. And I pray that you will make the right choice, that you will choose God, because only what we do for Christ will last. Only what God, what we do and be directed by God, that's the only thing that's going to last. Because people are up today and down tomorrow. They'll love you today as long as you're doing what they say and they got power over you, and you're doing like they want you to. They're taking your power. And then if you're hurt and you keep a grudge or unforgiveness in your heart, you're giving away your power. Anytime somebody can come in the room where you are and change your attitude, change your spirit, change your atmosphere, they have power over you. So take your power back. Glorify God. Let God know, God, I submit, I surrender unto you. Because when Jesus came and he was crucified on that cross and he rose again on the third day, the word of God declares that all power was given unto him in heaven and on earth. So if we're in Christ, we're new creatures. He said we are new creatures. Old things have passed away. So if your old life caused you to have low self-esteem, that you felt like you couldn't think for yourself, that you felt like all your decisions were wrong and whatever anybody else told you were right, behold, you're a new creature and you can take your power back. He told us in Acts 1:8 that after the Holy Ghost comes, so if we have the Holy Ghost, if we have the Holy Ghost that came on the day of Pentecost, that's power. That's power. That's power against anything the enemy comes against you with. So, people of God, if you have the Holy Ghost power, that's your power. Don't give it up. Don't allow people to drain you of your Holy Ghost power. Because some people will drain you of your power. So take your power back. Live for God. Acknowledge Him. Love Him. Receive ye the Holy Ghost, that you will have power against anything that the enemy brings to you. Because you are a child of the King. You are a royal priesthood. You are a peculiar person, a peculiar generation. You've been bought with a price. And you have the power to tell the devil and all of his imps, no, in the name of Jesus. I refuse to give you my power. I may have already given you too many years of my life, too much of my time, but as for me, within my house, I'm going to serve the Lord. So people of God, don't be deceived. Don't be tempted because you want to impress somebody. If you get arrogant because you got a secret and you kind of like bragging off of it, and then you mess around and talk too much or say too much and tell too much, and the devil know where your weakness is. So on today, people of God, it's time for us to take our power back. It's time for us to be strong in the Lord and the power of His might, that all things be done according to His will and His way. Take your power back. You're more than a conqueror. Take your power back. You're victorious. Take your power back. You don't need to impress man. All you need to do is obey God. Let's take our power back. Let's get in a hurry and take our power back. So to those of you that have not accepted Christ as your Savior on tonight, there's power, there's joy, there's deliverance, there's peace. Now, don't get me wrong, you're going to still go through things, but you have the power, if you have the Holy Ghost, you have the power to withstand and go through. Sure, you're going to stumble. Sometimes we stumble, we make mistakes, but if we desire, we can learn from those mistakes and take our power back. So you can ask Christ to become your personal Savior on tonight and tell Him you're sick and tired of being sick and tired and you want your power. You want to receive the Holy Ghost that they spoke of in Acts. You want to take Jesus to be your personal Savior. So call on God. He will answer your prayers and give you your power back. Glory to God. I pray that you have been encouraged by the word. I pray that God blesses you. I pray that you give your life to the Lord, because in times like these, we need the Savior. We need a true foundation. Jesus is the rock. He's the only rock. He's the rock of our salvation. And on tonight, my prayer for you is that you seek God, seek the Lord with all of your heart, all of your soul, all of your spirit, and get your power, your Holy Ghost power. Get it. Keep it. Guard it. And that God will bless you as you go on the journey of life for Him. In Jesus' name, amen. I thank you for joining us on tonight. I thank you once again for taking a little bit of your time out to listen to the Restoring Souls broadcast, because that is my heart's desire, is to help restore souls back to Christ. In Jesus' name, I pray with everything within me that this word have been a blessing to somebody. The lesson I'm learning from this conversation is to be led by the power of God and not by the need to be accepted by man. And I need to be the first partaker of this word and take my power back. I praise God on tonight. And I pray that you be able to be back with us on next Wednesday night. I pray that the Lord blesses and keep you until next time. We'll be back here again on next Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 7 Central Time, in the name of Jesus. And I would like to thank God for our sponsor on tonight, CT Management Solutions out of Newport News, Virginia. Phone number 757-272-4885. Again, that's 757-272-4885. And if you would like to email us, go to restorationconfmin.love@yahoo.com. Again, that's restorationconfmin.love@yahoo.com. Or you can give us a call at 919-391-6250. Looking forward to hearing from you and hope you'll be back again with us on next week. I would like to thank Pastor Nino and the TMA radio broadcast for allowing us this time. May God bless you. May He keep you until we meet again. In Jesus' name, good night.
You have been listening to Restoring Souls to Christ radio show. That was your radio host, Pastor Brenda D. Wilson. Join her each and every Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, where there will be a word from the Lord to encourage you. Hey, my brothers and sisters, remind yourself, don't let nothing steal your power. Don't let no one take your power from you. Amen. That power in which we have is given from God. Don't let nothing, no pain, no headaches, no friends, no family, no one take your power. Amen. Glory to God. What a wonderful message on this evening that encouraged us today that we're going to keep our power. Amen. Using it for God's glory. Hallelujah. To help somebody along the way. Continue. We'll be back. So stay tuned. Somebody, amen, amen. Listen, we want to say that we are praying for those that were affected by the Hurricane Michael. Amen. We continue to be praying for those in the Florida Panhandle where they had a lot of devastation. But we know God is still in control. Amen. How bad it is, you know, it's easy for us to say when we over here safe. But we just want to take time to pray for our brothers and sisters from across, amen, the highways and byways over in another state. Amen. Those that are affected, we pray that they get what they need, safety and help. Amen. And togetherness. Amen. I tell you, all this stuff, you know, it just brings us together. You know, it's sometimes sad that a storm has to bring us together, because I don't think that when somebody's in trouble that we're going to fight. I don't think that when we're in trouble, like when a storm or hurricane or tornado come, that we see color. We just need someone to help us. Amen. Amen. Ain't no racism. Amen. When you need some help and you in life and death. Amen. Come on, somebody. Amen. So sometimes things happen. Amen. That to bring us together. But in the midst of it all, we pray for safety. Amen. For our brothers and sisters, those that have lost homes, we pray that they be restored. Amen. And that most of all, we pray that they are at least know who God is and pray. I'm praying for those deliverance. Amen. And we're praying for those peoples. Amen. Affected all over this nation. Listen, brothers and sisters, we invite you to tune in just a bit, 9 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, for Men to Men Talk Back, the Talk Up Show, with your host, Pastor Nino, and co-host, Pastor Carl. So again, we want you to tune in at 9 o'clock. Our topic on this evening is, where are we as a culture of people? You know, you need to be tuned in tonight. You need to get on the phone and say, look, they're going to be talking about some things. This is something that it affects us as a race of people, as a culture of people, amen, in this nation. And so tonight, amen, topic question tonight is, where are we as a culture of people? And I want to raise that question up on this evening. And we have a special guest, amen, coming on to join us tonight. Amen. It should be a powerful conversation tonight. Amen. I tell you, y'all better tune in tonight. Oh, at 9 o'clock for Men to Men Talk Back, the Talk Up Show is going to be right. Amen. Because we need to get busy, and we need to get our mind refocused. And you know, our grandparents, they might have not had much, but they had some dignity, they had some pride. I don't want to get into it right now. I want to save it. I want to save it for 9 o'clock, because I want to save it, because I'm geared up, because I want the best for our people. And I'm not prejudiced. I want the best for everybody, but our people, hey man, our culture is the one under the attack here in this nation. We are the one where people continue to look at daily. And so we want to talk about these things. You know, how far have we come? Where are we as a culture of people today? That's going to be powerful. Amen. Thank you so much again for tuning in for Restoring Souls to Christ radio show. Amen. Once again, your host every Wednesday night at 8 o'clock is Pastor Brenda D. Wilson. Make sure you meet us back here on next week at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And we'll see you at 9. God bless you.
Second or another minute, not an hour of another day, but at this moment when my arms outstretched, my knees remain away, as you have done so many times before, through a window or an open door, I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. Trials that come to me, me strong. la, la.